Immortal, invisible, God only wise, in light inaccessible, hid from our eyes, most blessed, most glorious, the ancient of days, almighty, victorious, thy great name we praise. Unresting, unhasting, and silent as light, no wanting, no wasting, thou rulest in might. Thy justice like mountains, high soaring above, the clouds which are fountains of goodness and love. To all life thou givest, to both great and small, in all life thou livest, the true life of all. We blossom and flourish as leaves on the tree, and wither and perish, but not changeth thee. Great Father of glory, pure Father of light, thine angels adore thee, all veiling the sight. O Lord, we would render, O help us to see, 'tis only the splendor of light hideth thee. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, and with your spirit. And a very warm welcome to you all tuning in for this Mass, to our parishioners of St. Bridget's and St. Stephen's, and to all of you who are tuning in from different parts of the country and different parts of the world. You're most especially welcome here to the Lady Chapel of St. Stephen's on this, the third Sunday of Lent. And our Mass today is offered for Val Lomas, Ida Teasdale, and people of the parish. We're remembering especially also those lately dead. We're still remembering in our prayers Maureen Gallagher, her mother, Lorraine Chan, and the family in this time of grieving. So we pray for them during our Mass. In the first reading today, we hear of God's commandments. But God's commandments, Christ tells us, are summed up in two: love of God and love of neighbour. On these two hang the whole law and the prophets. So we are called to love God and our neighbour. So as we begin our celebration today, let's ask the Lord's pardon for the times we've truly not expressed our love of God in our lack of love for our neighbour. Lord Jesus, you were lifted up to draw all people to yourself. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Christ Jesus, you shouldered the cross to bear our suffering and sinfulness. Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison. Lord Jesus, you opened for your people the way from death into life. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, author of every mercy and of all goodness, who in fasting, prayer, and almsgiving have shown us a remedy for sin, look graciously on this confession of our lowliness, that we who are bowed down by our conscience may always be lifted up by your mercy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus. God spoke all these words. He said, I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery. You shall have no gods except me. You shall not utter the name of the Lord your God to misuse it, for the Lord will not leave unpunished the man who utters his name to misuse it. Remember the Sabbath day and keep it holy. Honour your father and your mother, so that you may have a long life in the land that the Lord your God has given to you. You shall not kill. You shall not commit adultery. You shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbour. You shall not covet your neighbour's house. You shall not covet your neighbour's wife or his servant, man or woman, or his ox or his donkey, or anything that is his. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. You, Lord, have the message of eternal life. You, Lord, have the message of eternal life. The Lord is perfect. It revives the soul. The rule of the Lord is to be trusted. It gives wisdom to the simple. You, Lord, have the message of eternal life. The precepts of the Lord are right. They gladden the heart. The command of the Lord is clear. It gives light to the eyes. You, Lord, have the message of eternal life. The fear of the Lord is holy, abiding forever. The decrees of the Lord are truth, and all of them just. You, Lord, have the message of eternal life. They are more to be desired than gold, and the purest of gold, and sweeter are they than honey, and honey from the comb. You, Lord, have the message of eternal life. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. While the Jews demand miracles and the Greeks look for wisdom, here are we preaching a crucified Christ. To the Jews, an obstacle that they cannot get over. To the pagans, madness. But to those who have been called, whether they are Jews or Greeks, a Christ who is the power and the wisdom of God. For God's foolishness is wiser than human wisdom, and God's weakness is stronger than human strength. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Glory to you, O Christ, you are the Word of God. Glory to you, O Christ, you are the Word of God. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me will never die. Glory to you, O Christ, you are the
from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, Lord. Just before the Jewish Passover, Jesus went up to Jerusalem, and in the temple he found people selling cattle and sheep and pigeons, and the money changers sitting at their counters there. Making a whip out of some cord, he drove them all out of the temple, cattle and sheep as well, scattered the money changers' coins, knocked their tables over, and said to the pigeon sellers, take all this out of here and stop turning my father's house into a market. Then his disciples remembered the words of scripture, zeal for your house will devour me. The Jews intervened and said, what sign can you show us to justify what you have done? Jesus answered, destroy this sanctuary and in 3 days I will raise it up. The Jews replied, it has taken 46 years to build this sanctuary. I am going to raise it up in 3 days. But he was speaking of the sanctuary that was his body. And when Jesus rose from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scripture and the words he had said. During his stay in Jerusalem for the Passover, many believed in his name when they saw the signs that he gave. But Jesus knew them all and did not trust himself to them. He never needed evidence about any man. He could tell what a man had in him. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I don't think I'd be wrong in saying that sometimes all of us get angry. It may be we get angry at someone or at something. Maybe something that's gone wrong or something that's not gone according to plan. Sometimes we get angry at a situation. Maybe when we see an injustice done to a loved one or even a stranger. Sometimes we get angry because we feel helpless. And at other times we get angry because we know we can change things if we were given the chance. Anger is an energy which can be used for good or for ill. In the Gospel today, Jesus is angry. But his anger is not an uncontrollable rage. His anger is directed at change. He doesn't just rush into the temple and create havoc. No, he has seen what has been happening, and so he sits down and he makes a whip, plaiting the threads to make a cord. But this takes time. Jesus' anger is controlled and specifically targeted, not simply at the sellers for selling, but at the sellers for their extortion. Jesus would have been used to temple sellers. They were part and parcel of the fabric of the building. Many of them were selling various animals and birds to be bought by the people as offerings for sacrifice. If you remember, when Jesus himself was presented in the temple as a baby, his parents brought two young pigeons as their offering. Most likely Mary and Joseph would have bought these two young pigeons in the temple precincts. So what angers Jesus is not the sellers selling, but the sellers selling have turned the place into a marketplace. There's extortion and profit. And rather than putting a stop to this, the authorities are turning a blind eye to the racketeering that's going on under their very noses, probably because they're taking a cut themselves, who knows. What is clear is the house of God has become a house of extortion, and the poorest of the poor will be the victims. They always are. Jesus is angry at the situation, and his actions force a response from the authorities, and a response often leads to change. Whether it does in this case, we never get to know. The Gospel doesn't tell us. The apostles who were with Jesus describe what Jesus does, not in terms of anger, but in terms of zeal. They remember a piece of scripture. In other words, Jesus is zealous that right is done. Jesus is zealous that the house of God ceases to be a place of extortion, ceases to be a marketplace, and it to be restored to a place of worship. Now, where do we fit into all of this? Well, I think we fit into what happens next. When Jesus is accused of having no authority to do what he has done, Jesus says, "Destroy this sanctuary, and in 3 days I will raise it up." And then the Gospel tells us that Jesus wasn't referring to the building, he was referring to himself. Jesus is the real temple, and we worship God in Jesus. We bring our offerings to Jesus, who offers them to the Father in his self-giving offering on the cross. By speaking of his own body as the temple of God, Jesus makes clear that our lives, our bodies, are sacred. And just as he cleansed the temple So we must allow Jesus to root out of us all extortion and sin, so that our lives become holy and our hearts become a worthy place in which to worship God. Our very humanity, as God intended it from the very beginning of creation, before the fall, our very humanity is restored in Jesus. And it is in baptism and through baptism that we come to know ourselves as truly created in the image and likeness of God. And because we are created in the image and likeness of God, then we too are temples of God. St. Paul to the Corinthians puts it like this: Do you not realize that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit, who is in you, and whom you have received from God? You are not your own property. You have been bought at a price. So use your body for the glory of God. We are temples of God, and God dwells in each and every one of us. Jesus prophesied this. He said, If anyone loves me, then they will keep my word, and my Father will love them, and we shall come to them and make our home in them. So on this third Sunday in Lent, we are reminded of our beauty and of our dignity as children of God. We are reminded that our bodies are sacred and must be ever ready and fit for God to come and make our home within us. And the surest way we do that, to do this housekeeping, if you like, the surest way we do that as Catholic Christians is to remain faithful to the sacrament of reconciliation, confession. It's not been easy during this pandemic. But when we come out of this pandemic, there must be a real return to this sacrament, this wonderful sacrament of healing and mercy. Because by this sacrament, we humble ourselves. We cleanse the temple of our heart from the extortion of sin, so as to be what God always intended us to be, a worthy and beautiful temple of God. As the poem by George MacDonald called The Temple of God reminds us, and the last few verses read this. And where man is any day, God cannot be far away. But the place God loveth best, the place where he himself can find rest, where alone the prayer God seeks, is in the spirit of the meek. To the humble God doth come, and in his heart he makes his home. We profess our faith, and in our Lenten time we're using the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Dear friends, St. Paul tells the Corinthians in today's second reading that what we preach is Christ crucified. No greater reality exists of God's love than the sacrifice of Jesus on the cross for us. Confident then of such great love, let us present our prayers and petitions. We pray for all those who do not honour the sacredness of life and the dignity of the human body as a place where God dwells, his living temple. That all humanity will value life as God's gift and treat every person with the dignity and respect that is their right as children of God. We pray to the Lord. Lord, bless your people. Lord, bless your people. Lord, bless your people, redeemed by your blood. We pray for our church buildings, and for all buildings built to the honour of God and for the worship of his people, that they will always have the financial support of those who use them and the respect of the communities in which they are built. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, bless your people. Lord, bless your people. Lord, bless your people, redeemed by your blood.
We pray for all those who are alone, isolated, and feel unloved or uncared for, and for all those who are suffering in any way because of the COVID-19 pandemic, that they will not lose hope. We give thanks too for the vaccination program and pray that the vaccines will be generously shared throughout the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, bless your people. Lord, bless your people. Lord, bless your people, redeemed by your blood.
We pray for all those whose marriages and family relationships have been strained or broken down during this time of pandemic, and for those families struggling to make ends meet at this time. May our prayer for family life be always matched with practical help and support. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, bless your people. Lord, bless your people. Lord, bless your people, redeemed by your blood.
We pray for all those whose loved ones are missing, left home, or who have died. May Mary, who knew the anguish of her young son being lost, and who felt the pain of his later death on the cross, pray with us as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Lord God, you commanded us in Jesus to love you, our God, and to love our neighbour as ourselves. Let these prayers be a symbol of our love and trust of you and of our fellow men and women. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever.
Upon thy table, Lord, we place these symbols of our work and thine. accept them, Lord, from thee they come. We take them humbly at thy hand. These gifts of thine for higher use we offer as thou dost command.
Pray with me that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Be pleased, O Lord, with these sacrificial offerings, and grant that we, who beseech pardon for our own sins, may take care to forgive our neighbour, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning are ceaselessly at work, so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings, and pour out on them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we were once lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love. Your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more, giving you thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead, and looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis our Pope and Malcolm our Bishop. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom, until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints, in the halls of heaven. With the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Saint Joseph, our husband, with the blessed apostles, the martyrs, our own patron saints and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly now commend to your mercy. Then, freed at last from the wound of corruption and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my own peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign for ever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the living Lord be with you always, and with your spirit. If you're isolated with someone, then please offer them the sign of peace. If you're alone, like I am here, then we just pray for peace in our troubled world.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. As I do every week, I'm offering my communion for all of you still in isolation. This might be the last time we do a recorded Mass. As we come out of lockdown, perhaps you'd offer your spiritual communion for all of us, and for the success of the vaccinations taking place, that this will be our last lockdown. We pray for that. Might you offer your communion for that. And also, that coming out of this lockdown, that those maybe who have been estranged from the Church in the past might be welcomed home, might come home back to the Church, back to their faith. Perhaps you'd offer your communion for that too.
Just the two masses, one on Sunday in each church. and then the church will be open during the week for Mass also. Let's hope and pray that it's the last time we need to close the church. I'll do a little recording, a little 5-minute recording, which you can watch, just to thank you for all this time of recordings throughout the last 12 months. And we just hope and pray that this perhaps is the last one. So a big thank you to you for tuning in, especially if you're not from the parish. It's been very nice to welcome you. Even though I can't see you, it's been nice to welcome you here and to share some of our liturgy here in the parish. So may I wish you all a very special blessing. Some of you, I suppose, will be remaining in isolation until you've received both vaccines. So we will put on the website a little link so you can find other masses, but we'll be stopping the recording masses after today. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Direct, O Lord, we pray, the hearts of your faithful, and in your kindness grant your servants this grace, that abiding in the love of you and their neighbour, they may fulfil the whole of your commandments, through Christ our Lord. The blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives. Thanks be to God.
Unless a grain of wheat shall fall upon the ground and die, it remains but a single grain with no life. If we have died with him, then we shall live with him. If we hold firm, we shall reign with him. Unless a grain of wheat shall fall upon the ground and die, it remains but a single grain with no life. If anyone serves me, then they must follow me. Wherever I am, my servants will be. Unless a grain of wheat shall fall upon the ground and die, it remains but a single grain with no life. Make your home in me as I make mine in you. Those who remain in me bear much fruit. Unless a grain of wheat shall fall upon the ground and die, it remains but a single grain with no life. If you remain in me and my word lives in you, then you will be my disciples. Unless a grain of wheat shall fall upon the ground and die, it remains but a single grain with no life. Those who love me are loved by my Father. We shall be with them and dwell in them. Unless a grain of wheat shall fall upon the ground and die, it remains but a single grain with no life. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Peace which the world cannot give is my gift. Unless a grain of wheat shall fall upon the ground and die, it remains but a single grain with no life.